want to leave you with this one verse, and it's the exclusivity of Christ, which speaks loud and clear here in Acts 4:12. And there is salvation in no one else, for there is no other name under heaven that has been given among men by which we must be saved. And again, for this particular spot, for many people, that was a point where they realized that He was it. He was the one. He was the Messiah. So that, to me, makes this an incredibly special place, and I'm sure for many of you as well.
God Almighty, worthy is the Lamb, worthy is the Lamb, you are holy, holy are you, Lord God Almighty. Worthy is the Lamb, worthy is the Lamb. Adon hod malchuto mukaf betifalto ve'haolam isman, haolam isman ote atzmo ve'or ve'choshech lo yachdo.
Oh, to praise how great our debtor, daily constrained to be. Let thy goodness, like a fetter, bind my wandering heart to thee. Prone to wander, Lord, I feel it, prone to leave the God I love. Here's my heart, oh, take and seal it for thy.
The Godhead three in one, Father, Spirit, Son, the Lion and the Lamb, the Lion and the Lamb.
how great is our God. Sing with me, how great is our God. Oh, we see how great is our God. Name above all names, worthy of all praise. My heart will sing how great is our God. Name
a rich man, all day long I'd biddy biddy boom. If I were a wealthy man, I wouldn't have to work hard. Yabba dibba dabba dabba dibba dabba doom. Lord, who made the lion and the lamb, you decreed I should be who I am. Would it spoil some vast eternal plan if I were a wealthy man?
Adonai, gadol Adonai, nashi kulam gadol Adonai, ibu kulam gadol, gadol Adonai. How great is our God. Sing with me, how great is our God. And all we see how great is our
beside the temple there. I heard the children singing, and ever as they sang, methought the voice of angels from heaven in answer rang. Methought the voice of angels from heaven in answer rang. Jerusalem, 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 lift up your gates and sing, Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna to your King. And then methought my dream was changed, the streets no longer rang. Hushed were the glad hosannas, the little children sang. The sun grew dark with mystery, the morn was cold and chill, as the
Jesus, my Savior, waiting the coming day, Jesus, my Lord. Up from the grave he rose, with a mighty triumph over his foes. He arose a victor from the dark domain, and he lives forever with his saints to reign. He arose, he arose. Alleluia, Christ
changed. New earth there seemed to be. I saw the holy city beside the tidal sea. The light of God was on its streets. The gates were open wide, and all who would might enter. And no one was denied. No need of moon or stars by night, or sun to shine by day. It was the new Jerusalem that would not pass away. It was the new Jerusalem that would not pass away. Jerusalem,
Jerusalem, sing for the night is o'er. Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna. ur ha'olam she'yarad el ha'choshech pakachta enay be'orcha yofi vechen le'libi ha'kamea lichyot la'netzach le'tzidcha. Reni lefanecha, ishtachavelecha, ure bekolata, Adonai. Ata kol kach yafeli, ata kol kach raui, ata kol kach nifla, lechayai. King of all days, oh so highly exalted, glorious in heaven above. Humbly you came to the earth you created, all for love's sake became poor. Here I am to worship, here I am to bow down, here I am to say that you're my God. You're altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me. It goes to see my sin upon the cross. I never know how much it goes to see my sin upon the cross. Hareni lefanecha, ishtacha velecha. ובכל אתה אדוני אתה כל כך יפה לי אתה כל כך ראוי אתה כל כך נפלא לחיי. Here I am to worship, here I am to bow down, here I am to say that you're my God. You're altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me. Thank you.
And then finally, the Apostle Paul, in what is clearly the most profound discussion of resurrection anywhere in the New Testament, in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, he declares this: "But now Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who are asleep." What Paul had just got done saying the previous 8 verses was, you know, if there is no resurrection of the dead, Jesus was not, did not rise from the dead. And if he did not rise from the dead, then your faith is vain. It is empty, it is meaningless, it has no substance to it. Furthermore, you think your sins have been forgiven. Bad news, they are not forgiven. And furthermore, you know the people we talk about have gone to be with the Lord? Not so. It hasn't happened. And then the icing on the cake is, we are the most pathetic people on the planet. We believe this myth, and we bet the farm on it. But that's when Paul says, "But now Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of the resurrection." And so, when Paul says, "Recall," when we take communion, we recall what has happened. Jesus says, "Remember," and that's what we want to do.
I think we would all agree this lady has the major contribution of our industry.
Name one thing that was a highlight of your trip.
Okay. Well, I do believe I'd have to say I'd have to say the highlight of my trip here in Israel would have to be the which one was it? There's just so many.
We just need one.
Probably trekking around Jerusalem and seeing all the sights and sounds, you know, taking in the scents, and just getting a real grasp for the life and the lifestyle of the Israeli people, the Jewish people, seeing how all their cultures kind of interact, meld.
Is that all?
I do believe so.
Okay, cool. Thank you.
Hello.
So, hello.
Can you tell us one thing that was a highlight of your trip to Israel?
Wow.
My mother's mother.
One thing, Lonnie, one thing.
Choose to burl the water.
I think Caesarea.
Jim?
Magdala was great.
Yeah.
Lonnie's answering for you so far.
What's that?
He's answering all your
questions. Right. Well, I think Jerusalem and the Temple Mount was probably a highlight, specifically. So, because that's, like Dr. B said, the biggest piece of real estate in the world. So,
Temple Mount.
Very cool.
The most thought after, really good, that's for sure.
Yeah.
Awesome. Thank you.
He has really
highlighted the trip.
Yep.
It's hard. There are three, but I think I would boil it down to Lucia Valley because of my experience the last time. I sat by the shore for a whole day and thought of everything that happens by the Sea of Galilee. But the trouble is, it's also the garden today, the garden tour.
Yeah.
Especially with Canada. And there's others, but I'll let you know.
Golly, there's so many. Probably the garden tomb.
Yep.
And the beautiful flowers that were.
Yeah, garden's a highlight.
Yep.
Like the kids in the back room.
She's a lot more brief.
That's okay.
You erase whatever it is they said before.
Dr. B, they're telling us a highlight of your trip. Go for it. Let's say it again.
You had to say it again. So
highlight.
My highlight of the trip was Paul Benware. I mean, first of all, we couldn't have done this trip without him.
This is
and
true.
Second of all, we called him King Paul because he was so high and mighty. I mean, he was such a wonderful teacher.
He was so arrogant. I mean,
and he even dressed like him.
That's right.
Almost. Wow.
Dr. B, did you have a highlight of your trip?
It was just being with you and Scott.
That's your highlight?
That was it.
Okay, next person.
There's so many highlights.
Okay, Brent can tell us one.
I don't know. There's been so much stuff that I've been suspended with. I'd have to say probably the baptism for myself.
That was awesome. That was cool.
That was a highlight
for
most of us. Yeah.
Yeah. When Steve,
you come
out, it's been unbelievable. Yeah. Here, more than I ever could expect.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Very cool.
Awesome.
Cool.
Thanks, Leah. Yeah.
So, tell us a highlight of your trip.
Highlight of my trip. Capernaum.
I like that.
And that would be Peter's, it would have been technically his mother-in-law's house. Where Jesus would have been staying with them, and just finally figuring out where Jesus told Peter to go throw a hook in the water, catch a fish, and you will find a shekel in that fish's mouth. To be right there on that spot, that passage hit me.
Well, always today, the garden tomb was always moving. Probably, before that it was Caesarea with the story of Cornelius the centurion. It kind of gave me new information that I never realized before, and I enjoyed it. The thought that he was really the first, he was that first Gentile that Peter brought into the church. Those two things right offhand.
I wanted to say my favorite part of the trip was I got to learn and understand the Jewish people in a much more deeper way than I ever thought I'd ever be able to even realize in my mind. I come from an area up by Chicago where Jews were Jews and they were going to screw you if they could, and my mind was very confused and mixed up about them until I come here and really got to see how really special, how loving and precious.
Can you folks sit down there, Beth?
They'll always stay with me for the rest of my life. It's changed me. It's changed my whole outlook.
You hear that, Ben?
What was your favorite part?
What was my favorite part? Well, first thing is to visit the places that Jesus has spent time in and was, and for the fact that I got to be baptized in the Sea of Galilee was absolutely my favorite, and to have strangers become friends in the group.
Yeah, awesome.
Spend the time with him.
Yeah, thank you.
You too. Okay, so tell us in a sentence or two a highlight of your trip.
The people.
Love it.
People.
I already told you.
You can tell us again.
Well, the baptism at the Sea of Galilee was beautiful. It was a profound thing that I saw.
Yeah, that was cool.
Nazareth.
Nazareth?
Yeah, it's old. God is unfathomable, by the fathers, by the prophets, and this last day is spoken of by his son.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, doctor, what was the highlight of your trip?
Curing everybody's medical problems.
He helped me the whole time. Okay, highlight of your trip?
Seeing more of the world, traveling.
Susan's stories.
Yeah.
Being with the Canaanite.
That's right.
The Canaanite.
She's the queen of the Canaanites.
Oh,
my, with my family.
Nobody said this. Because it's all wonderful. Obviously, Mount of Olives for me, because that's where Jesus is coming back. Garden Tomb. It's all, I think it's the baptism. There's so much. Nobody mentioned the food.
Yeah.
Food. But I think it's lower list compared to everything.
Yeah.
But thank you.
Okay, go ahead.
So, tell us the highlight of your trip.
It was Magdala and the Garden Tomb.
Good answer.
Sea of Galilee.
Masada.
How about...
Oh, yeah, Masada.
Masada and the Jezreel Valley.
Masada. Yeah.
Kelsey's baptism was awesome.
Yes, it was.
That was
a tearjerker. Watching you come up and out.
Yep.
Okay, so tell us one or two highlights of the trip.
The Sea of Galilee on the boat was a highlight. Another one.
No, you stole mine.
Well, you could both have the same one.
Yeah, that, I think that was, and the baptism.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep.
Thank you.
What did I enjoy most about Israel? Well, number one was the group. How could we have just had the most wonderful group to be with, and the love of the country. I mean, I hated to leave. It's like I fell in love with the people and with the, this is our home. Like Moshe said, it's like God, there was no mistake that we were in Israel. We were there because we were called to be there. And I just hope that the Lord calls us back again. And I hope that we stay in touch. And if not, you know, I know that we're going to see each other in the kingdom, and I'm just so happy about that. So, sayonara.